everyone. I know my background's different. This is my bedroom. I don't know. I just felt like sitting somewhere new today. I was actually taking a nap, and my boyfriend woke me up and was like, I'm finally awake. When do you want to go to lunch? And so he doesn't want to go to lunch until later. So now I'm sitting here not falling back to sleep and wondering what should I do? And I decided I'd do a video. And last time I filmed this video, it was like 10 minutes long. So I'll try and do it quick. So I want to do a video on clear skin and how I got clear skin and how I maintain my skin. I do suffer from breakouts. I do have dry combination skin. I mean, I couldn't use a lot of products when I was growing up. I remember I tried using stuff from vinegar to salt scrubs to lemon juice to just pretty much anything, every single drugstore cream cleanser or any kind of cleanser I've tried, from Neutrogena and Clean and Clear, Acuvue, anything proactive. I've tried everything. And what I do and the steps I take to get clear skin has definitely changed. I mean, I do use a lot of products and I do take a lot of vitamins. And that's the main thing. You have to take your vitamin. Now, I'm first going to kind of show you and talk to you about my different vitamins that I personally take. I'm not saying that you should take all the vitamins that I take, but the one thing that I definitely recommend is taking a multivitamin. Incorporating my multivitamin into my daily regimen, daily routine, daily life schedule has definitely changed, because not only was taking all these separate vitamins just kind of helping, but this has stepped it up a lot, and it's definitely took me from trying to kill a pimple every single day to trying to get like rid of like one or two a week. So that's pretty awesome. So taking a daily multivitamin is very important. I would definitely recommend going to GNC. They have really good ones, or go to your organic store, Whole Foods, and finding a multivitamin. That's a really good one. Definitely try and find one that's targeted towards women or teens or boys or girls, because not every woman should be taking the same multivitamin a man should, and not every man should be taking a multivitamin a woman should. So definitely try and find the one that's targeted towards you, as a man or a woman or a teen or whatnot. So I love the ones from GNC. I got this one from GNC. There are so many like vitamins and minerals in here that are so good for you. I can't even list them all to you. So definitely take your multivitamin. I definitely recommend the one from GNC. That's the one I take. And that's the one that's like took me from this to this on a scale of 1 to 10 on skin. And I love it. So definitely take your daily multivitamin. Now, aside from taking my multivitamin every single day, I take a few of other things. I take evening primrose oil. Definitely helps with clearing skin. Vitamin E oil. I also take, my mom told me this the other day, because I was telling her my cheeks were breaking out real bad with from dryness. She told me to take one of these little capsules to poke a hole in it and just like put it on the areas that needs healing. So on my cheeks, you can see I have like four little pimples. They're just like random. They make a square. But I put it on those before I went to sleep last night. And I just kind of put this all over my face in conjunction with my extra virgin coconut oil. I use just regular straight unrefined coconut oil. You want it in the purest form. And I put that all over my face before I go to sleep at night. That's my moisturizer. I do have a separate moisturizer I use. This is the Dramatically Different gel from Clinique. I use that before I apply my makeup, but before I go to bed at night, I put the coconut oil on. It's in my bathroom, and I totally forgot to get it, or else I'd show you. Hold on. Okay, so this is what the coconut oil looks like, the unrefined kind. It's all organic, all natural, so mine's all like melted to the side, because coconut oil melts at a very low temperature, and once it gets above like 76 degrees, it's like starting to melt. So mine got a little warmer because I had it in my bathroom and it just went into a liquid. So I put this on after a shower all over my body from head to toe, all the way down to my feet. You can even put it in your hair if you want as some kind of moisturizer and hydrating thing. So I always put that on at night before I go to bed. Also, I take Biotin because it's good for your hair, skin, and nails. It helps your hair grow faster, which is good for me because I got this really nasty haircut in February and I've been trying to grow my hair. So my hair went from my shoulders to the top of my bra. Whoops. Which is here. The top of my bra. Really cool. I take flaxseed oil because it's really good for you. Helps you sleep at night too. And I take also coconut oil in the pill form because it also helps with weight loss. My mom is like proof of that. She flukily discovered that, I should say. And it kind of looks like a horse pill. And you're supposed to take 3 of these a day. So those are the other separate vitamins I take. Now, what I do face-wise with lotions and soaps and stuff like that, I use Clinique, the liquid facial soap for dry combination skin. I think there's only one kind of soap. If there's one for oily skin, and you have oily skin, go find the one for oily skin. After I use that, I will use my Dr. Andrew as well for Origins Mega Mushroom Treatment Lotion. Now, what I love about this is it's natural and it will not hurt your skin. It won't burn, it won't sting, it won't nothing. I can't use the toner from Clinique because it's too harsh for my skin. It makes my skin worse than better. So if you have really, really sensitive skin, definitely check out the Dr. Andrews line at Origins. I would definitely, definitely check them out. And they have a good return policy. So if you didn't like it, then you can always return it. Also, like I said before, I use the Clinique gel. I also use the Dramatifying Gel from Clinique. And because I have redness and I don't buy foundations that are for red skin because I feel like it makes me darker and a little more redder and I want to look the color of my neck, not the color of redness. So to cross cancel that, I use a green redness solutions corrector and it literally is green. I'll show you. Whoops. You see, it looks white on camera, but it's green. And you just like rub it into your skin and you don't see it anymore. Ta-da! But that's really awesome. So if you have red skin, hints of red patches, definitely check out Clinique's Redness Solutions. They also have like a lot of drugstore green color correctors that you can check out from L'Oreal. I don't remember who else has them. I'm sure a lot of other places have them, but definitely check them out. Because I have a large area and I need extra moisture, I just use one that's kind of like a moisturizer instead of a concealer. So that's pretty cool. So, yeah, those are the things I do to help myself keep clear. Definitely check out your multivitamin. It's definitely going to help you. It's definitely going to give you clear skin because you're healing your body from the inside out. Definitely drink lots and lots and lots of water because you're flushing out impurities and toxins from your body. So that's very important. I know a lot of people have talked about Clinique and different things like that. It's just something that worked for me. But the one thing I'm pressing is to take your multivitamin. That's not something a lot of people say here on YouTube that they take or what they do. So if you have taken those steps, you know, using your 3-step system from Clinique, definitely incorporate your multivitamin. That is very important. So I will talk to y'all very soon. I hope you guys found this very informational and kind of eye-opening and eye-brightening. So yeah. I will talk to y'all very soon. I'm sure I'll be back in my polka dots next time. So I'll talk to you soon. Bye-bye.